Previously known as Kabalega Falls, Maxon Falls is a spectacle waterfall where the White Nile bursts through the narrow rock gap and trembles some 140 feet into a pool known as the Devil's Cauldron. Before flowing into the tranquil Lake Albert, British explorers Samuel and Florence Baker named Maxon Falls after the president of the Royal Geographical Society, Roderick Maxon. The local name, Kabalega Falls, is a remnant of the former president Idi Amin, who had renamed Maxon Falls to Kabalega Falls in reference to Omukama Kabalega of Bunyoro Kingdom. Daniel Opio, the ranger guide to Maxon Falls, says these are the most powerful falls in the world.
Consider this one because this is where River Nile squeezes itself through a narrow gorge between the rock, 6 to 7 meters wide. 43 to 45 meters deep, where water tabulates at 6,000 cubic meters per second. There's no any other waterfall in the world where water tabulates at 6,000 cubic meters per second.
Opio also reveals that the fall is another historical waterfall known as Uhuru Fall, which was formed in 1962, the same year Uganda got her independence.
This is the world's most powerful waterfall, or the strongest waterfall in the world. When I talk about waterfalls, we always hear about Niagara Falls in Canada, we hear about the Victoria Falls in Zimbabwe, we hear about Iguazu Fall in South America, we hear about the Rhine Fall, even from China, there's another waterfall between China and Vietnam. So there are so many waterfalls.
Away from the waterfalls is Maxon Falls Conservation Area, which comprises the National Park, Bugungu Wildlife Reserve, and Karuma Falls Wildlife Reserve. The 1,483 square mile park is the largest in the country and is home to 70 mammal species and 450 species of birds.
If you're a tourist, definitely you'll never go wrong with game sighting.
The park is known for its large population of the big three: leopards, lions, elephants, buffaloes, and rhinos, plus the chimpanzees. These are easily seen as one drives through the park.
We have got about 76 different types of mammals, over 452 bird species.
When in the park, one gets a chance to go on a three-hour boat cruise along Albert Delta for a good view of several mammals, such as hartebeest, commonly known as the African antelope, giraffe, elephants, buffaloes, and hippos walking by the grassland shoreline, while reptiles such as crocodiles flock to the riverbanks to cool themselves.
As you cruise, you are meant to see the mighty Murchison Falls, which is also regarded to be the most powerful waterfall in the world. So from the boat, you see it from a distance, but all in all, again, if you are to drive and reach the top of the falls, you experience it much more. You feel the real power of the water.
Baguma explains that despite being the most enjoyable experience in the park, the boat ride, however, has numerous scares.
For people who may have or who may be addicted to swimming, we discourage them strongly not to do it, because when you make it in the water, you can either hit the rock, you can meet a crocodile, you may bump into a hippo, but as long as you are within the area, within the boat, so there's nothing I would say is more scaring.
Despite attracting tourists throughout the year, park visits were greatly affected by the COVID-19 outbreak. While on its way to recovery, the park was once again hit by the Ebola outbreak, which caused many tourists to cancel their bookings.
So actually, the tourists, it's very low at the current situation. It's very low. We expect maybe times to come that we get back to our normal.
It's not been an easy ride. It's been a bit bumpy. The latest bump was Ebola. So we are hoping for good things in 2023 in the hospitality industry. Hopefully, if the international tourists fail to come. More and more Ugandans will learn to appreciate their beautiful country and travel to some of the spots, including Murchison Falls National Park.
Murchison Falls National Park is accessible by car and by plane and is a popular site for wildlife viewing, hiking and bird watching. Report compiled by Rachel Nachwala for the news.